Let us perform convolution sum between the given two discrete time sequences. X of n is given as a shifted form of delta function with varying amplitudes, and similar is the case for h of n. Thus we extract x of n and arrange it in a sequence form as the amplitude levels are 2, minus 1, plus 1 and plus 3, where this arrow points that a sample which is at origin is having an amplitude of minus 1, and to the left of that is at n equal to minus 1, there is a sample with an amplitude 2, which is shown with del of n plus 1 signal. Similarly, for the impulse response sequence, we extract its amplitude levels as 3, 4, 2, where we could note here that the first sample of h of n is at n equal to 1. So, to decide the starting point for the output, we find out starting point for x of n, starting point for h of n, add both of it. Presently, it results into minus 1 plus 1, 0. Hence, our output will begin at the index n equal to 0. So, we solve this example using the matrix method, where we have arranged h of n as row elements, x of n as column elements. All the entries of the matrix, they are obtained by multiplying row and column elements respectively. Then we partition the product values, and followed by that we have added the diagonally arranged elements to finally obtain the output sequence y of n. In this example, we perform the convolution between a unit step function and an impulse response which is of exponential form. Being a discrete time sequences, we calculate its convolution sum. So initially we write down its basic formula, y of n equals to x of n convolved with h of n, where summation goes from 0 to n. Originally it is from minus infinity to plus infinity. But since our input sequence is a unit step function, and also h of n is getting multiplied, 2 raised to n is getting multiplied with the unit step function, the starting point or the lower limit of summation, that is minus infinity, has now altered to 0. So here we choose x of m with the unity amplitude and h of n minus m, which is 2 raised to n, is here replaced with 2 raised to n minus m. This example, this particular step is to be solved using a finite geometric sum series formula. So making use of a finite sum series formula, where according to the standard formula, a is here 2. Rather, we can arrange it as 1 half raised to m. So a is there 1 half. So after simplifying this expression, we get the final output y of n. In another example, here we perform convolution between two discrete time unit step functions. So initially we have sketched x of m, which is unit step function, an impulse response which is a shifted unit step function. By change of index from n to m, both the sequences are plotted, as follows. After h of m, we obtain the folded form of h of minus m. And after folding, as we perform shifting, we realize that h of n minus m, whose first h is bounded by the limit n minus 3. As you could note here in the folded signal that the first point, the starting point of h of minus m was minus 3. And the signal exists for minus 3 onwards till minus infinity. So when we arrange h of n minus m for h of n minus m, it will become here a generalized value of shift. I can write as h of n minus 3. That means beyond h of n minus 3, the impulse response is 0. Then we further shift this signal towards right. So as we shift it towards right and it overlaps with x of m, the limit of summation, as is obvious, is bounded between the lower limit as 0, which is decided by x of m, and upper limit of summation is decided by n minus 3, because beyond n minus 3, h of n minus 3 doesn't exist. That is how, after putting down these limits for the summation, the output of the convolution sum is as given here. In another example, where both x of n and h of n are rectangular functions, this we can obtain